Eagle Feather, you know you folks aren't supposed to be in this here car.
We have permission to be here.
Really? And where's your reservation?
South Dakota.
You're just a bunch of savages!
Savages? Where? I think you folks ought to break up camp here and go back to your own car. I wonder who told them to come in here.
Who do you think? A certain scruffy little prairie chicken named Annie Oakley.
Somebody call a maid?
She's been nothing but troubles first moment she joined us 6 weeks ago.
I told you I was sorry about little Jason Friday Wig.
If only she hadn't been wearing it at the time.
Charlie Denford, I insist you give her a piece of your mind.
Give her a piece of yours, if you think you can spare it.
You really hate me, don't you?
He sure does. Why does he hate poor Miss Tate? Why does everybody hate poor Miss Tate?
That does it! Either that person stays or I go! Ugh.
I know she seems kind of mean and heartless, but underneath she's really a totally rotten person.
The only time we get alone is while Dolly's eating.
She got you. She's dead set against me seeing Tommy.
On account of me being one half Indian.
What's the other half?
Irish.
What a small world. I'm half Irish myself.
No fooling.
Sure am. Tommy, don't let Dolly get you down. Indians are real fine folks. The Irish I'm not too sure about.
Oh, Annie, I almost forgot. I cut this out of the newspaper for you. It said something nice about you.
About me? Oh, fooling.
Well, aren't you going to read it now?
Nah, I think I'll just save it for dessert. Come on, little Jake, we got work to do.
But I'm hungry, Annie.
Homework's important, little Jake.
How's a person supposed to learn to read and write if you don't teach me how?
But I'm powerful hungry, Annie.
All right, go on over to the eating car and fill you up. And then, learn me how to do some reading.
No use, Tommy. We can't get married. We don't have a plug nickel between us.
People aren't going to have what we're going to have, Winnie.
You mean poverty?
It doesn't matter how much you have, Winnie. It's who you share it with.
What is my dear will be yours when the sun shines and when it pours. Summer, winter, fall or spring, 50-50 in everything. Haven't got much, even that much. Can't get it, but just the same. My earphones.
something. Frank!
Now oh, that's a rap party word.
Frank.
You calling me?
No, I was just trying to learn little Jake here how to do his reading. But he sure is thick-headed. Ain't you, little Jake?
I sure am thick-headed.
Right. Now, go on the eating cart and get yourself.
What did I just say?
Well, you're a grown boy. Go on, eat again. Go on, skip.
I was just reading something about you and me in the paper. You want to read it?
Nah, here it is.
Nah, I want to hear how it sounds when you speak it.
Frank Butler's assistant, whose name was not mentioned in the program, only performed one trick, but promises to become a fine marksman.
Hurry on, pass of that pipe, man.
Folks are beginning to notice you, man. Just the other day, I saw Carolyn putting your name on the billboard.
And on the program, too?
What the hell? Why not? I told him I was going to accuse that egg off Poodle's head. Think you can handle that?
Can I? I can do it without breaking the yolk.
Great. We'll start in Cincinnati. But you don't want to be moving up too fast.
All I want to be is softer and pink. Like the kind of girl you said you liked.
Gotta say, softer and pink
every day. That ain't just a load of hogwash, is it?
What would you say if even one day I decided to make you my partner?
You can't mean it!
Never really wanted a partner before, but maybe now I just might. Butler Randall.
Oh, I can see too. Oakley and Butler.
Butler and Oakley. It has to be alphabetical order. An old joke since rule.
If you say so.
That's for sure.
Am I your girl?
Oh, I don't know. I haven't really thought about it.
Well, think about it.
None of it looks better. There's none better, too.
I've been bathing regular.
Thank you.
Mosey on back with you.
Nah, you best stay here. We'll both sleep a lot better that way.
Annie, you gotta help us.
We're facing an emergency. Pony Bill's opening up against us in Minneapolis.
And he's signing up Sitting Bull, the famous Sioux warrior.
So we gotta come up with a big attraction of our own.
And a woman who can shoot like that and look something like a lady is a pretty good attraction.
We want you to do that new trick you've been practicing.
Shh!
Not so loud! Saving that surprise Frank.
You can surprise him with it in Minneapolis. I'm sure he likes her a little.
He likes me, I think.
He hasn't asked you to marry him yet, has he?
Well, but he ain't quite that high yet.
I gotta get him, Charlie. What can I do to get him?
What you gotta do is dazzle him, Annie. Drive him loco when he sees you step out there in that beautiful costume, looking like a million bucks with the lights and the music and that...
Instead of shooting that egg off that poodle's head...
You do this great trick that you perfected just for him, you'll save the show and marry Frank.
How does that sound, Annie?
Just like a fairy tale. Now you're sure he's gonna like it.
He'll love it. Who doesn't love surprises?
This is great, Annie. Just great. Come on, BB. We got a lot of telegrams to send to the newspapers.
Y'all ready for bed?
Yep.
Did you brush your teeth?
Yep.
All of them?
Yep.
Then get in there.
I'm
the show right out from under my nose. That low-down, dirty hound dog. He ain't nothing but lying, mangy, thieving, cheating Bill! You big man, it is great to see you. Well, if it isn't my best friend and old sidekick, Barney Bill. How the hell are you, young pirate? You fellas know Chief Sitting Bull, the man who took down General George Custer. Never had the pleasure.
Oh!
Oh!
Business!
So, what can I do for you, old pal of mine? I came here hoping you would let me be professional courtesy. Let me take a gander out to you, Phenom, since you blessed all over town.
Oh, Andy, of course. I'd be delighted. Back, take our distinguished guests and place them in my crowd box.
Fine, fine. Come on. All right, time to get ready for the show. Move in.
Good face.
Wait till you see your shoot, Chief.
So, are you thinking of joining up with Pony Bill, Chief?
No. On my way home from Washington.
What were you doing there, Chief?
Went to see the Great White Father about Indian territory.
Oh yeah, I heard they gave you a bad shuffle with that piece of land there, didn't they?
Nothing will grow.
That's too bad.
Yes, too much oil.
Just oil? Boy, that's a tough break, Chief. How you gonna live? You can't drink the oil.
No, I have to sell the oil. Sell 50,000 barrels a day.
50,000.
It's worth a try.
So, tell me, Chief, what are you planning to do with all that wampum?
Planning to open up a gambling hall in my reservation.
A rotten idea, Chief, but for a relatively small amount, you could be a major backer of our Wild West show.
Sitting Bull lives by three rules. Don't eat red meat. Don't get feet wet. And don't put money into show business.
How the hell did we ever get this country away from them?
So!
What? Poster's terrific, ain't it? You like it, right?
I like it raw. Her picture's bigger than mine.
I figured you'd be pleased to see it, you being stuck on her and all.
Stuck on her? Whoever said I was stuck on her? Even if I was stuck on her, which I ain't saying I am, I'd love to stay stuck on her, which is something I couldn't do unless I was top dog. Any man would understand, Charlie.
What was Frank so head up about?
He doesn't like Annie's poster.
I was afraid of that. Sure we ought to go through with her big surprise?
Oughta? We gotta. If Annie doesn't draw big business, we won't have enough dough to get out of town.
All right. I better go make sure everything's ready.
Charlie! I can't find Winnie. I've looked everywhere for her. Something bad has happened to her. I can feel it in my bones. There's only one person who's low enough to hurt a person sweet, innocent, almost as pretty as I am, baby sister.
I didn't do it, I swear.
Behind me. I just want to be sure the coast is clean.
And we all know who that person is.
The coast ain't clear!
And it so happens she loves this half redskin.
And we plan on having a lot of little quarter redskins.
All you're doing is
that. If you mean that I helped a little, yes, ma'am, I sure did.
We just do love each other.
Isn't that all that matters?
What did I do to deserve this? If our mama was alive, she'd be turning around in her grave. Charlie, wake him. Quick, I'm giving you our notice commencing now. I'm leaving, and I'm taking my baby sister with me.
I'm sorry, sis, but I'm not leaving my husband.
That's what you mean. So it happens you're only 17 years old. You mean you're underage. As our legal guardian, I'll have it annulled.
Dolly!
I think you better let her go.
Let her go? Hell, I want to help her pack.
She really means it about having it annulled.
What if she does? Soon enough, you're going to be 18. Then you just null it up all over again.
Annie, look!
What? Lord, you scared me half to death. It's only me. It's me! Look, Kedar! It's me!
Isn't it exciting? Just yesterday you were
star as he is.
Go get Frank. I want him to see this.
There's no business like show business like no. Up and soon you'll be appearing. Every bit of nervousness is done. Then the sound that's music to your hearing, to hear them cheering when you come on. There's no light show. They smile.
Yep, shot up like a ragweed.
It's all hell, don't it?
I just hope you don't like it too much, because it ain't gonna be there next week.
What's that?
Well, Annie, I gave you a few extra tricks, but that don't add up to a star villain. It took me years to get that. You understand, don't you?
I guess so.
That's my girl.
That's the second time you said that. I've been feeling kind of funny lately, Frank. I've been hungry, and I'm always hungry. I've been staring at the moon a lot. Is that what love does to you?
Have you ever been in love before?
Oh, sure. Dozens of times.
I mean, with somebody who loved you back. My big flash pins.
But you just gotta, Stevie. You just gotta.
Oh, come on.
I've seen that old poodle trick a dozen times.
But this time's gonna be different. This time, I'm not gonna... What I'm trying to say is, when I get up there, music playing, all the lights shining on me, I'm gonna make you so dang darn proud of me, you're gonna
what?
Bust your buttons! And you're gonna ask me to do something, and to be something, and I'm telling you in advance, I'm gonna do it, and I'm gonna be it!
What if I were to ask you to dance? Right now?
No! That ain't the way I planned it! Besides, I gotta go get ready. Frank, could you touch me for luck?